One of this weekend's major tasks was to set up the greenhouse. As you can see, we have a poly greenhouse here. It was kindly put together by Ben and Emily, a couple of woofers who stayed here a few weeks ago. And in the bottom we have a gravel base. There's a weed mat underneath that which will help slow the growth of this grass through. Basically, since this has been set up, I haven't actually had the time to set it up so I can grow seedlings in here. But what I'm going to do is set up a tray system. You can see here we're using standard folding tables that you should pick up at any sort of hardware store quite cheaply. And then what we're doing is we're using some treated pine decking with some polytube and micro sprayers. And basically we're setting up a system that looks a little like that. Of course it'll have more plants and a lot less rubbish around it at that point. But basically what this system does is we have to put the treated pine slung between a couple of steel posts. It's hooked over the top and tightened with a bit of wire, which makes it really quite solid and strong. The steel posts are pushed into the ground, or hammered into the ground, and they rest on the edge of the table here and are held together with this. So basically it makes a really strong little structure. The polytube will come up here and we'll have an elbow here coming back down the steel post under the gravel and out into this area, and it'll actually go back through that little hole over there to where's the nearest tap. There is actually a timer on that tap which will turn these on automatically. Each of these two systems, there's one on either side and there's a back sort of work area. Each of these two systems will be independently tapped, so that if I only have enough, so one table is full and not the other, I can actually turn one side off or the other just to save a little bit of water. This table, as you can see, has the wire on it. The purpose of the wire is to allow really good drainage for seedling trays, whereas this table here and the one in the back has no wire on it at all. And that's for the tree tubes. The tree tubes can happily go on this, but if there's a choice, if they're all full, then I'll have the tree tubes sitting on here, which have their own stands and sit up about an inch off the table, and then we'll have the seedlings and the punnets on here. The idea is we get good drainage off both of them. In the longer term, I actually intend to build special little garden beds that will sit just underneath these edges here and just sit out slightly. For growing something like comfrey or the like. But in the meantime, what will happen is the water will flow off the tables, down onto the gravel, and then down into the subsoil, and run down towards the dam. In this area here, where the grass is currently, we will actually build some garden beds and plant various things in here to absorb that water and that nutrient and make good use of it. The other thing we're going to need to do is, as you can see, it's due north is actually straight up there. So if I keep walking due north and I turn around 180 degrees, there's my greenhouse, which is great because we've got a nice sunny position. We get lots of nice warmth in there. The downside of having such a sunny position is during summer, it's probably going to get too hot. So whilst those windows at the top will open and allow some of that heat to escape, we're probably going to need to do some shading of this as well. So certainly an option here would be to straighten up this sleeper here, these sleepers, put in a fence along here or a trellis, and maybe grow something like some grapes or some kiwi fruit up along here. They'll benefit from the water from the greenhouse, so they shouldn't need any additional water, and they'll throw good shade onto this greenhouse, dappled shade, during the heat of summer. But anyway, I'm going to get on with finishing this job off, and then we'll come back and have a look at it in operation. Well, as you can hear, the afternoon was a success. Well, partial success. You can hear that the sprayers are running. You can hear the water hitting against the sides of the polycarbonate here. Probably the system works beautifully. So what happens is we have the water on our timer in here. The water runs out along this tube. Now, this tube will be buried back at a later date. It runs down into the greenhouse at this point. It runs in there, it's got an elbow at that point that runs, and the tube runs back across the greenhouse. There's an elbow up to this sprayer, and then there's a T-piece over here that goes up to that sprayer. Down underneath here where the walkway is, the polyed tube has been placed into PVC pipe, which will prevent it being crushed as you walk, as we're walking in and out, so it'll just protect it. As you can see in there, I actually won't go in fully, but you can see that the sprayers are working beautifully against the vents there. The only problem, I guess, with this is that the sprayers I bought were incorrectly labelled. So these ones are actually quite a fine jet that sprays out, oh, I'd say probably about 2 meters under the pressure. So that the water, the sprayer, just this little sprayer in here is spraying out and sort of hitting this table over here. So it's actually getting the wrong effect. So the trick will be just to duck into a hardware store and pick up some new sprayers. They're very, very cheap. Those ones will just screw out and I'll screw new ones in. Now the new ones, they were supposed to be misting type sprayers, which will provide a very light, fine mist across both tables. I won't actually go in at the moment because I'm a little bit worried about getting the camera too wet, but you can certainly see it's running. It is operational. I wasn't planning on actually putting any seedlings in this week, but I will be certainly doing that next weekend. So as long as I can replace those sprayers over the course of this week, we'll be right for next weekend. And oh, there we are, it's turned off. So let's just go in and have a look. The timer has kicked in. And as you can see, it's spraying out quite a long way. It shouldn't be spraying out that far, but it really is working wonderfully well. So the system works very, very nicely. It's going to work beautifully once we've got some plants in here. Oh, just a quick mention, as I said, this area here is designed as a workbench for potting and the like. This little gap in here seems like a bit of a waste. What I'm actually going to do is, in that gap there, and up underneath here, towards the back of these tables, I'm actually going to bring in some house bricks and place them in there. The idea of the house bricks is they will provide a thermal mass, which will collect the heat through the day that's in here, and then re-radiate at night and keep in here just a little bit warmer. But anyway, as you can see, quite a success. Certainly the system works beautifully. I just need to fix those sprayers and wear away. So in the next few weeks, no doubt we'll come back in and revisit this, and we'll actually have a look at what's growing in here.